It really was a revelation for me. I said, this isn't about dogs at all. This is about people. This is about us. I said, let's call it being human. Essentially, what they reveal in one word is vulnerability. And that's why people chuckle, because partly it's we're looking at people we know and met, types, and partly we see, yeah, that could be me. Man Ray is the first dog. It wasn't as if Bill got Man Ray as a subject to be photographed, but when he did acquire Man Ray and he took him to the studio, because you have to keep these dogs occupied. Man Ray hated it when he was doing any work. It didn't involve Man Ray. So Man Ray would sit in the corner and go, mm-hmm. So Bill said, okay, come, let me photograph you, kind of thing. Oh, Man Ray was happy. He'd take a photograph and then Man Ray would, again, another photograph. So it became a sort of natural thing. Man Ray dies after, I think, about 10 years. Fay Ray comes on the scene. He finds that there's a difference in character. And so he develops a new body of work with Fay, and then she has her litter, and he learns again that each of the puppies has his strengths and weaknesses. Batty is like liquid. Whenever she was sat in a chair, she would just droop all over it, melt all over it, whereas Fay was much more a kind of regal and prima donna-ish about it. Bill's work is so fluid and organic because it comes from the heart. My favorite work in the exhibition, the dog is Candy, and the work is called Casual, and it's got this bright sweater, a knitted sweater, and she's extremely relaxed. She looks like a well-heeled urbanite, very sophisticated, probably lives in a very modern house, is at ease with herself and her life, maybe a tiny bit bored. That's the image I keep coming back to as the essence of the show. I think one of Bill's great strengths is he has principled ideas about his work, but he's willing to bend them. And jump back to the beginning of his career, he believed that photographs should be black and white, and they should be the size of a page of a book. That's the correct place for photographs. And suddenly, he's confronted with this big camera, big pictures in color. And to his credit, you know, after a little resistance, he says, okay, let's go with this. And this Polaroid material lasts a long time until the disaster happens, collapse of photographic civilization. Polaroid goes bankrupt. And so all the photographers who have now learned that it's a medium that suits their interests and they assume will go on forever, they realize they're gonna run out of materials. He realizes that the handwriting is on the wall. He's gonna have to find a new medium, not just for himself, but for the dogs, because the dogs will have an existential crisis if they can't be photographed. He does some research, you know, he's logical, he's scientific, and he comes to the conclusion that he will go digital. About this transition, he's always said, you can't be nostalgic. Photography should be of its time. So don't cling to something just because you're used to it. If it's fading away, jump to the next thing. And I think that's a good lesson for any artist, especially in our time, where media can change like this in a question of a couple of years.